Today we are following the science at Guitar Tone Central, following the science of pickups. You're gonna love this. Hi everybody, welcome to Guitar Tone Central. I'm Mark, and we are here with our friend Bo Bice.
Nice to see you, Mark.
Good to see you again.
It's always good to be back, buddy.
Same here, man. And we appreciate all of you being here as well. And what we're talking about today is the science of pickups. Now, we know that pickups look to be a pretty simple kind of device.
Yes.
This is a pickup mounted in one of our Somnium cartridges, and you see some poles here, and these are magnets. And before we get into the actual science of what these things do and how these things work, share, like, and subscribe to our channel. Just click down below, click on the notification bell, and that way you can find out when our next episode is coming. Make sure you don't miss it. And thank you very much. We appreciate you being with us today. So talking about, you were about to take this pickup up.
You picked up the cover to the pickup, which exposed all this wonderful material underneath.
Yeah, we don't always see what's the inner workings of these things.
Never get to see that until we do the reveal.
Yeah, this one appears to be pretty tightly wrapped. I'm not too tightly wrapped, but that's just my wife's opinion. But yeah, Bo's right. They're very simple. You've got a coil, if you can hold that up so folks can see it. You probably know this already, but hey, for those of you who haven't seen one opened up, that's a coil of copper wire that's wrapped around a spool. And in the middle of the spool that poke out through these covers, these are poles, but they happen, in this case, they happen to be magnets. They're not that way in every pickup. Sometimes you see a blade, a metal blade. Sometimes you don't see anything. All you see is a cover.
Yeah, like a hot rail pickup or something like
that. Right, right. So you don't see that kind of thing. But on this type of a single coil, very common, this is how they're made. But what you might not know is the science that goes into this. It may seem real simple, coil, spool, magnet. But why the tone comes out so different? Man, there's an awful lot to it. So one of the things, what do you look for when you're trying to figure out, I know you've listened to pickups for some of your own guitars. Yeah. Do you ever consider like the technical specs of it, or do you just listen to them?
Well, you know what, until I started to really delve in more into the pickups and to wiring, watching someone wire pickups, I didn't ever think about anything but the tone. Mm-hmm. And I've got a friend of mine that he builds pickups, and I've watched him sit and actually do this.
Do the winding and all that.
Absolutely fascinating, because you're right, to see someone take materials like this and be able to make a tone out of them. And also to make a tone that's so different, because these all get put in different positions in the guitar, and they're gonna pick up a different tonal value inside the guitar.
Now, what if you had a way to know kind of in advance how that pickup might sound?
No.
That would be a trick. Now, that's the interesting thing. There's a new guy that I've met. His name is John, and he's putting together a website called Guitar Pickups Database, or the guitarpickupdatabase.com. And we'll have a link for that down below. But when you see these things on manufacturers' websites, wherever you go, Seymour Duncan, DiMarzio, EMG, whatever it might be, they're going to list some specs for you. They're going to list what type of magnet it is. Like, these are ceramic magnets. Might be an Alnico magnet. Makes a difference to the tone.
Absolutely.
A lot of times they're gonna list the wire resistance, because when you put a meter on this, you know, that's more turns of wire, and depending on the wire gauge is gonna give you a different resistance, which sometimes translates into tone difference, sometimes not. Because we've done demos here of some Dean pickups where we had two pickups that had the exact same resistance, but a very different tone.
Oh, right.
Yes, that's you'd think that's surprising, but it's really not, because what we're gonna do, and I haven't shown any of this to Bo yet, he's seen them put together.
Right.
We're gonna take them apart. And we're gonna play one taken apart.
Fascinating. I've never even done that or never thought to do that. So
well,
that's
you
cool.
You would wonder, okay, how does this thing actually work, right? It usually, if you're going to generate a signal, create electrons to come out the wire, that's kind of like a generator, right? So when you have a generator, generators usually spin. So you have magnets that spin inside a big coil of wire in that housing, or you have coils of wire that spin and the magnets are in the housing, right? So either the coils are moving or the magnets are moving and signal comes out.
Right.
All right. So what's moving here?
Well, same issue is you've got the movement from the string and sending down through the magnets.
But is the string the magnet or is the string the coil? Because one of the two needs to be moving.
Correct. Well, the string's going to be the coil. It would be what is sending out the actual signal.
Well, we're going to find out because that's what we're doing here today. And the way we're going to do it is we're going to figure out which part matters more. Do they both matter? Can I have a pickup without a coil or without magnets? Well, we know we can't have one without a coil because you got to have wires to send a signal out.
Right.
All right, but can we have a pickup without any magnets? Because I thought that was the essential part of it. But here's one of the interesting things. There's a certain spec that doesn't get mentioned a lot on manufacturers' websites because resistance, the coil resistance, you almost always see that. But there's another factor called inductance. And inductance is the resistance of a coil, of a signal to change. It's the coil's resistance to change in that flow of signal. And I don't need to get, it's a little more complicated mathematically. We don't need to do that. We just need to play guitar around here. So, but what I did do was I took one of these babies apart.
Oh, cool, man.
So when you take this pickup apart, here's our coil. And we took the top part of the spool off, and these are all the magnets. So
that is cool, Mark.
These are all loose. So now, is this going to play without any magnets? I wanted to know. Now, how do we test to see is there really a difference between these two? If there is, maybe one will play and one won't, or maybe there's no difference. So what you folks at home probably don't have. Some folks have a gadget called a multimeter, and that's what they use to measure the resistance, you know, of these coils. So this is the same brand of pickup, and it's exactly the same model. So what we're going to do, we're going to look on our resistance, and we'll get it with the camera. So I'm going to measure the resistance of the coil. Bo, you tell me what it says.
Sure.
Of this pickup with the magnets in it. Let me hold it down. Go ahead. What do we got?
We have 6.29.
That's holding that 6.29?
It's holding at 6.29.
All right, let's measure its twin brother here without magnets and see what we got.
Ooh, 6.13. So you've hardly made that much of a difference.
Not much of a difference in resistance. That's very close. Okay, but what difference do the magnets make? Well, that's where inductance, if these magnets affect how that signal is resisted and how it travels through the coil. So there's a special meter called an LCR meter, and they're inexpensive, and it's one of the things that Guitar Pickup Database, they're going to be measuring these type of factors. Let's see if we get the same difference. We're going to switch it to inductance.
Okay.
So we're going to look at the first one again. So let's see what the inductance is.
Right now, we have no reading on that. It's just a one.
Oh, am I on the right setting? I am not on the right setting.
Okay, there we go.
There we go. So what do we got?
We're looking at a 1.87 hold.
1.87. What that means is, in inductance terms, it's a measure called Henry's. So it's 1.87 Henry's?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the higher the Henry's, generally, you're going to have a darker sound and more output. Okay. We also know generally we associate with more resistance with more output because you have more coils generating more signal, more wire. And so now our Henry's are at 1.87. Now this is the same coil of wire because it's the same pickup just with the magnets removed. Let's see if the Henry's are pretty much the same.
we're looking at 1.18.
Okay. So that's a whole half a Henry. That's a good 30%, 35% drop in Henry's. So what that tells me is that this coil's reaction to a current and resistance to current is going to be different than this one. Now, without any magnets in it, is it still going to play? Now it's no longer really a full pickup.
Full pickup.
So first let's show the folks at home. We don't need this anymore.
Well, I've got a quick question, man.
I mean, yes, sir.
I've never seen anyone do this. So you have to understand, I'm kind of taken aback because I would assume no, the answer would straight out just be no.
Well, how about you play these and we'll find out.
Well, that sounds like a great idea because I'm convinced that this isn't going to work. So,
all right. And I have not gone over any of this with Bo. This is kind of the cool thing about our little science class here today. but now there's another thing. Let's make sure, just because there aren't any magnets in here, right? That you'd think there wouldn't be any Henrys, but yet there are. So is this still magnetized or not? So I'm going to take out my little handy dandy magnet field tester.
Yeah.
So what this is, there's a little magnet that's in here that pivots in all directions. It's able to pivot. It's very, very lightly balanced. So when it gets near a magnetic field, it can point to that field. So the red part of the bar is the north and the blue is the south. So if red points to something, then you're pointing to a south field because opposites attract, and so on and so forth. So let's test that. So here's our pickup. Here's our tester. Well, let me hold this one for this demo because I'm gonna move this thing around a bit. So if I just hold this thing and I bring this closer.
Oh, wow.
You just saw that thing turn.
Yes.
Okay. And if I rotate.
That is awesome.
Then the meter rotates, because what did I just do? I'm pointing to the south pole of the pickup, of the magnet that's pushed through here, because the red is the north on this gauge, and that means it's pointing to south. But if I rotate it the other way, now blue is pointing to this, that means that's the north pole of the pickup.
Okay.
And you notice that right now it's not doing anything, and as I get
a little closer,
I get within 6 inches, it already detects it, even from that distance. So your magnets are throwing off a magnetic field detectable at least that far. And of course, it's going to get stronger. It's trying to suck this in and hold it on there. But that's what we have. So it's the same thing. These are pulled out. So if I want to insert these and I want to make sure when I'm building these pickups that they're all pointing north, then I'm going to use this meter and make sure that blue's pointing at this, that's my north, I'm gonna make sure that's that, in that same direction. Now, when you have pickups that have reverse wound and reverse polarity, so that you have kind of a humbucking effect, even though you have single coils, you would check this, you would flip it around, you make sure that the red side is pointing. So now you got your south pole is pointing up. So this is a way to build the pickup and make sure you got all your magnets straight. So, let's see how magnetized this thing is.
Let's do it. And we've got nothing.
We got zilch. Zilch, absolutely zero, nada. Absolutely nothing. Dead. All right, so we have Henry's. We have zero magnets. That's just so you folks know at home. There is no magnetization. Apparently, this coil didn't hold any magnetism from having those magnets in it. So what we're going to do now, we're going to put this back together. Okay. We've already got one of these in a cartridge. We're going to put this in our other Somnium cartridge, and we're going to come back, and we're going to play. We're back, and we've got our dismantled pickup mounted, and I wanted to just go over one more time. We've got our little handy-dandy magic wand magnet tester, magnetic field detector.
Yeah.
So we're going to put it by this. You can see already that sucker's moving as it gets near the magnets. So it's pointing.
Yeah, that's cool, man.
Yeah, it's wherever I move, it's that blue side pointing towards the north poles on that. So now we're going to put it over here by this.
Nothing.
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 So we got nothing at all. But we definitely got field there. So just want to show you folks that we've got nothing up our sleeves, nothing absolutely between our ears, and we're just doing this straight up, okay?
Nothing in between our ears. I think that there's some people out there that would agree with that.
Yeah, probably. All right, well, let's start out. Bo's going to strum a few chords. Let's see what we got with our standard single coil.
Standard. And this is a beautiful little pickup.
All right. So, oh, by the way, we're also putting it in the neck position. You have more string vibration, right? The more you get to the middle, that string vibrates more. So we got maximum signal in there. Just another little, you know, little technical geeky point of interest. Yeah. Just that's why we're in the neck, but it'll, you know, it'll work in both, but let's rock and roll. What do we got?
Still a little bit of heavy cordage so we can hear it.
It plays. It's a miracle. No, it's not, because it's what it does. Okay, now we get to test just the empty coil, no magnet field, whatever. Let's see what we got. And Bo has not played this yet, so he doesn't know what to expect.
I don't know what to expect, and I just so you know, if I'm going to throw it out there, I don't think this is going to work. That's just my two cents. We'll figure it out because I've never seen this done before.
Yeah, because the magnets are still out of it. They're right over here.
We're going to see. Yeah. We're going to see. This is an awesome test that you have this on. This is why I love having Guitar Tone Centrals, because we can do this kind of...
We do the nothing between our ears kind of stuff here practically weekly.
Yes. Practically weekly. So let's do the same cordage.
You got the volume on?
Yes, sir. Got her all the way up. Let's do the same cordage, though. Actually surprised that we even got a tone out of that.
Well, here's the thing. Remember when we measured this, right? We measured the resistance was the same because it's a coil of wire. It's going to have resistance, but then its capacity for resisting signal, the Henrys were different, but it was still there. The Henrys weren't zero. Okay. You had like 1.86 Henrys, 1.68 Henrys for the regular magnetized pickup and 1.1 something for the coil with no magnets in it. So there was still a potential for it to generate a current, but obviously less. So how is the sound different though?
For me, it sounded a lot like if you wanted that kind of tone from an old Dan Electro or something like that, that had a little bit less output. You know, and it had a
thinner
little
kind
thinner
of a sound.
Tone. Just it had a little less volume to it.
It was quieter.
It was quieter, but it had that tonality of a softer pickup. So that's why I can absolutely I can understand scientifically why you're saying that this worked, but it's a little hard to digest just watching
now.
Someone do this. Yes, and I did come in cold on this, so this was a trick on me, is what I think it was. This is absolutely fascinating.
Well, we're not even done yet. Go ahead and put that one back in. Yeah,
okay.
Put it back. Now, while Bo's doing that, Dan Electro, the lipstick tube, pickups actually also have a very lower Henry, much lower Henry rating typically than like these or humbuckers. And that's why you get that thinner sound. So that's one of the cool things about using Henrys as a measurement is that if you're looking for that kind of thinner, twangy, surf rock, jangly sound, you know what to look for. If you were looking through a database of different brands of pickups and you wanted something that had that kind of sound and you wanted it in your guitar, well, you would look and say, okay, this is down 1.1 Henry, something like that. It's probably going to have that same light, airy, thinner, lower output tone. And that way you're not going to, if you see that it's got, you know, two Henrys, well, now hang on a second. That's probably none. That's going to be a little bit more output, darker tone. That's not what I want.
Right.
So that'll help you decide when ordering, instead of spending your money, wait for it to come in, wire it up or pay someone to wire it up, and then it's not what you were looking for. So that's one of the cool things about guitarpickupdatabase.com is they're going to be cataloging all this kind of stuff. So now, here's the thing. What happens if we put the magnets back with the coil? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to take a magnet here that came out of that, and I can't put it into the coil, but what if I put it near the coil? Let's go ahead and pluck a string, and I'm going to put the magnet by that string. Go ahead. Just keep plucking it. Let's do that lower string. Let's do it on the D string.
Okay. That is cool, man.
See, it's getting a lot louder. You got a lot more output when that magnet gets right at the coil. We measured more Henrys when the magnet was in the coil.
Right.
More output. Move it away without that magnetic field, less output. But the cool thing is, this doesn't have to be in the coil.
No, that's what blows my mind, that you just were holding it right over the string.
Yeah.
I'm taken aback by that, man.
Well, what that means, and this is something that I learned recently, is that I asked you the question, if there's got to be a magnet and a coil moving somehow, it turns out that it's the magnet that's moving. Because when I bring this over here, that magnetic field is going into the string, okay? So, where are you at?
I'm on the B.
On the B.
That is really cool. Who's the real hero here? We now have figured out who the real hero is, right?
Well, they both work together, but the thing is that you need the magnets to create a magnetic field in the string so that when the string moves, the string is, it's a very weak magnet, but it moves and it creates that current. And of course, the stronger the magnet, because we see as we get closer, when it comes to designing pickups and building them for tone, whether you use a ceramic magnet, an Alnico 2, an Alnico 5, how strongly these are magnetized, the stronger the field, the higher output. This is like a recipe. Right? For those of you who just, it's a coil and it's some magnets, what's the big deal? I can wind those at home. There's really, why should I pay? There's some, boutique pickups that are, you might pay $200, $300 for one.
Right.
I've seen for one, but the difference is like night and day, depending on how they're built. There's really, this is why we're following the science. There really is a science to this, and so many different factors that go into the recipe, how this is wound. Is it wound from the bottom up, from the top down? Is it scatter wound randomly? Is it wound from the middle first and then out to the sides? All these things change how the tone flows out of it. And that's the exciting thing about experimenting with pickups. And that's why, there's so many different pickup companies out there producing these things, because you can cook up, how many different recipes are there for spaghetti sauce, right? Or, or chocolate chip cookies. They're all going to be different and in a good way. It's just a matter of how you apply that recipe, what ingredients you use, the magnets, the gauge of the wire. Yeah. And that's why it's cool that the guitarpickupdatabase.com is going to have a way for you to chart this stuff and really side by side compare it. And of course, eventually, as they build their database, you'll be able to hear it. So definitely check out their site. And they do ask for players to send them an email, let them know about a pickup that might not be on their database. So if you have something at home that may be in an older guitar, something you don't see in their database, or maybe a brand, something new on the market that you don't know really what the specs are, how it might sound, let them know. Let the manufacturer know so that we can catalog this. So we have a place to go, one central place to hear everything. And of course, we If you bought a Somnium guitar, you'd have one central place to test them all.
That's right.
So this has been a lot of fun. I was curious to see the look on Bo's face when...
it blows me away. I have to say, Mark, this was something I'm so glad that I get called in cold to do some of these things for Mark. And I love doing them every time because you teach me new things. And it truly, truly expands my knowledge and love for the guitar. So this is a great place for players to just come and really find out more about tone. That's the name of the show. And you do a great job, you and the team here, man. It's
well, thank you.
Very great job.
It.
I'm stunned that this works like this.
Yeah, it's. I was surprised too. You have to just accept the science that it's the we measured it. There's potential for tone there. And now we know a little bit more than we did yesterday. So thanks, everybody, for stopping by and visiting with us. Bo, thank you again
for
hanging out with us and letting me surprise you, a little shock and awe here with some crazy stuff. But tune back in. We'll see you again next time on Guitar Tone Central.